Welcome to the airplane. Today we're going to have a look at a couple of emergency drills. Specifically, we're going to look at the single engine operating procedure in the Piper Aztec. This can be simulated by using approximately 2200 RPM and 10 inches of manifold pressure to simulate a zero thrust engine. But today we're actually going to continue into a full feather and shutdown of the left engine. So with any airplane you're flying, you want to be very familiar with the emergency procedures, the checklists and the drills, and we want to make sure that we keep sort of reading over them.
Hospital area traffic, Foxtrot off of Foxtrot, system 180 on close, currently 13 miles to the north.
And giving them a practice every now and again so that in the hopefully very unlikely event that it does happen, it's not a nasty surprise for us. Being familiar with your cause checks and not forgetting to cycle through ignition sources just in case only one of the magnetos is stopping the engine from running by having its timing out of position is a very important part of your emergency drill. The altitude, the amount of time you have available, is going to dictate what happens. So we have an engine failure immediately after takeoff, we're just going to lower the nose and land straight ahead. If we have that engine failure at 10,000 feet, we've got a fair bit of time to make radio calls, pick a site to glide to for an emergency landing, run through some cause checks, complete passenger briefs, and so on. Traffic, Piper Aztec Golf Whiskey, India, Quebec is approximately 7 miles north of the field. 6,500 feet will be 6,500 feet just above the field practicing single engine drills. So control power drag, that's your kind of big ones. Control the airplane, get the power all up, and then clean up any drag. So if we had flaps down or gear down, we'd want to get them retracted. And then identify and verify, so identify what engine is dead. Verify it, so identify could be dead foot, dead engine, so you know I'm keeping us straight by using the right rudder, my left foot's not doing anything, the left engine should be dead. Verify that by looking at instruments. Got to be careful about using RPM because that windmilling propeller could still be making RPM, so an EGT can also help back that up. Then we do a cause check at altitude. If we were again low altitude, we just identify, verify, feather the engine, get that propeller control to feather, secure it, mixture item, cut off, shut off the fuel, and get around and get landed. At altitude, we do a cause check, make sure, oh, we forgot to change tanks, select the right tank, or cycle the ignition source, or get the carpeat on, as applicable. So we want to be very careful with what we're doing there. So we're just going to take this really steady and easy. We're well under gross weight, we're 6,500 feet, we're 4 miles from the airport right now that's below us. We're going to stay nice and close to the airport, and you want to make sure this is done very safely, and if you haven't done it with an instructor, you want to make sure you're doing this with a proficient, qualified instructor beforehand. But I do think there is a lot to be gained from actually practicing this. You also want to make sure you're going to do it when it's not too cold out, so you don't shock cool that engine. So I'm going to bring the power back on that engine slowly, go through everything slowly, partially because we're making the video, also partially because it's my airplane and I want to look after it, and because I'm a mechanic and I don't want to damage that engine. And it's fairly nice and warm out today, it's 12 degrees outside, so we're not going to be shock cooling that engine too bad. Definitely wouldn't recommend doing this below freezing. So we're flying along. The 1962 POH is pretty wonderful. I think it was written by the sales department, and the line basically, or the paragraph basically says, an engine failure in the Piper Aztec causes minor inconvenience. You know, you will slow down to a cruise speed of 135 miles an hour. I think it's going to be a little more alarming than that, but I guess they're trying to get across the point that it will fly very well on one engine. Okay, so I'm going to go carpeat hot. I'm a carbureted version. We're right over the airport now. I'm going to bring that engine back. Okay, so there we come. All the way back. Big shift there. Lots of right rudder. So, and now I'm going to bring that to mixture idle cutoff. Okay, so you can see we're still holding 2,000 RPM. The fuel is off on that engine. The throttle is closed. So identify, dead foot, dead engine. Sorry. Control, power drag, yep, identify, verify, we can see the EGT is gone, feather, alright, let's go ahead and feather that, huge difference there, there we go, Okay, there we are, 125 miles an hour with that power setting there. We're not working it too hard. About 23 inches of manifold pressure, 2300 RPM. Again, we could pick up more power if necessary, but we're flying along quite happily there on the one engine. Hey, I'd pick that engine up about 3 degrees to improve my single engine flying characteristics. And I'd get the rudder trim put in correctly to also assist. Got a bit of a turn here. Keep us nice and close to the airport. And I'm not going to fly with it off for too long, as I would definitely like to not cool that engine down too much. A little more rudder needed. And I lost a little bit of altitude. It's just doing it very slowly, so I'm just in a little bit of a climb here as I come around, just a couple hundred feet a minute. Okay, let's go ahead and restart that, or get ready to restart that engine. So ignition is on. I'm gonna bring the mixture rich. Pump the throttle 3 times and then close it. I'm gonna engage the starter. And I'm just going to let that engine warm up. Add a low power setting for a little second there. And now we'll go ahead and get everything else sorted out. Okay, not too bad. I did make a mistake in there, and that is I engaged the starter before moving the propeller control back to the cruise power setting. So, little note to myself, something to work on for next time. That was a silly little mix-up, but I want to get that propeller back to sort of a cruise power setting out of the feather detent before starting the engine. Didn't seem to affect anything really there, but that is the correct procedure. And I was going through the checklist on here, so that's no excuse for that. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe to learn about new videos that we've got coming up, and please check out the rest of our content. Happy tailwinds, we'll talk to you all soon.